Hey everybody, this is Ben with the hotdogcartstore.com and I am excited to be here today. I am sitting here with Mr. Jim Hood. He's got let me throw this up on the screen. That's he owns the Naked Dog out of Savannah, and we're going to be interviewing him. I'm going to bring him in here. There he is. And I would love it if you have questions during this. I'm going to be asking Jim questions, but if you have questions you want to ask, feel free to put them in the comments and we'll be happy to toss them up. Jim, I'm going to just start running through these. When did you start Vendi?
We started probably about 4 years ago, so we've been doing it 4 years.
And full-time, part-time?
We started out part-time, we're full-time now. We had another an Italian Ice franchise, which we still have that, so we do both.
Okay, and did what inspired this, Jim? What got you saying, hey, I gotta, you know, I'm gonna be a hot dog vendor?
Well, we had the Italian Ice franchise since 2005, and we were doing events on River Street, and the hot dog vendor left, and they asked us, hey, do you guys want to do hot dogs since you're doing the ice? And so we decided to go ahead and do that. And that was 4 years ago. So now we do all the events with the hot dogs on River Street. Plus we have a stand on River Street that we work pretty much every day.
Oh, wow. So you're running almost every day?
Every day. We're off on Mondays normally.
Okay. And do you get a lot of the, I know Savannah area, you get a lot of tourist area. What about through the winter?
Through the winter, the last couple of years, we've been closing like all of January and half of February. But this year, we've kind of stayed open since it's been in the 70s and everything. So we're kind of taking advantage of the weather right now.
But okay. Yeah, the weather's been, you were just telling me that y'all are fixing to have an 85 degree day here. I'm jealous. When's that, tomorrow or the next day?
That's Tuesday or Wednesday, they say.
Wow. Wow, that'd be good for vending. Have you branched out to the catering stuff we've talked about? I know you and I know each other, but have you branched out to doing private gigs and stuff like that?
Yeah, I have a concession trailer and we've done weddings. We do catering for like the pharmaceutical. And, you know, cater lunches at the colleges here. And we also do big events and the food truck festivals that they have here.
Good. I want to say good morning to Greg Crafton and David Bloom. Thanks for joining us. Boy, we have a light crowd. This is what happens when you try to get hot dog vendors to watch a live thing at 10 a.m. Most of them are getting ready for the day. This is you're off today. Now what? Tell me this, Jim. Do you work with your wife? Do you have help? What are you doing?
Just me and my wife right now.
Okay. And what do you love most about?
I mean, where I work, it's nice. It's great being out with the public. Like you said, you know, we're mainly tourists, so you know you get to meet a lot of different people. You know, you get critiqued a lot on your hot dogs. We do Chicago dogs, so everybody from up north will come down and kind of try to test us on our Chicago dog, and so that's pretty good because we can say, yeah, see, we can do it.
Oh, so you've gotten a good response on that? Because I tried the Chicago dog, and it didn't go over well in East Tennessee.
We do a ton of Chicago dogs.
Wow. We have a lot of vendors doing Chicago dogs, but here they think it's, you know, a salad on a hot dog and they, you know, why are you putting rabbit food on my hot dog? I could see that. I could see how a northerner where it's a famous dog would say, you know, would want to question the quality of a southerner's version of a you know, the Chicago dog. Are you using Vienna? Or are you using a certain brand?
We're using an Eisenberg hot dog. out of Chicago, but we're using everything else as Vienna. The poppy buns, the relish, the sport peppers, and everything else is Vienna.
Now, Mark?
Well, we were doing Vienna before the Eisenberg, and they came down and, you know, talked us into, you know, trying them, because I told them there's no way I was going to change. So we ended up trying them, and in my opinion, it's a better dog. So.
Wow. For the folks that have just joined us, we are alive here with Jim Hood. He has the Naked Dog in Savannah. It's called the Naked Dog Savannah. You can look him up on Facebook if you want to follow him. He's been vending about 4 or 5 years now. And Jim and his wife run the business. They do a little catering. They do a little street food vending. In fact, they're on the street pretty much 6 days a week there in Savannah. If you've never been to Savannah, you ought to go check it out. It's a beautiful, beautiful town. It's one of the oldest cities, I think, on the Eastern Seaboard, isn't it?
Right, yes, sir.
It and St. Augustine, I think, are the two oldest on the Eastern Seaboard. I love Savannah. It's a beautiful place. So tell me this, Jim, and I don't want to put you on the spot, but what would you say that you would do differently starting out, or do differently now even? What would you do different, maybe know previously?
Well, if we would have heard about you before we started, that would have been a good start. But just did more research in the beginning.
More of the due diligence?
A lot of, you know, trials and errors, you know, before, you know, we got to where we are now.
Right, right. And tell me this, what would you tell someone that's just starting out or considering the business or maybe started already that is maybe struggling? What advice would you give to someone new?
Advice on that. Just, you know, keep trying. Don't give up. I mean, it took us, when we first got our cart, it took us 4 months before the health department even okayed us to do what, you know, we do now. I mean, they would say, okay, well, you got to have this on your cart. So we'd go back and do that. And then they'd say, well, you got to have this on your cart. So we'd go back and do that. And I think in the beginning, you know, they were just trying to make us quit. And, you know, that's the major thing. Just don't quit. I mean, it's all good once you get going.
Do you keep it pretty simple on your cart as far as the menu, or do you have an expansive menu?
Yeah, we do the chili cheese, the slaw, the kraut, we do brats, we do Polish. We're going to, probably in about a week or two, we'll be doing the Italian beef on the cart. We're going to be doing, we got okay to do a fryer, so we're going to be doing fries out there.
Oh, wow.
We're going to do a greaseless fryer. So you don't have to worry about all the mess.
And it's, yeah, the air fryer.
Right. And then we're going to try some new different things because they okay. So we'll have our griddle out there. We'll be able to do Reuben sandwiches, grilled cheese. And one of the guys that used to come to our restaurant all the time, he loves the pancakes. So I think my wife's going to maybe start coming in early, maybe doing some pancakes or something. So it's you know, it's fixing to get where we're gonna have a lot of stuff.
That's a lot of work. The pancakes I've done on catering stuff. Like, you know, I've done pancake breakfast. I did a pancake social at a church once. They were trying to raise funds to build a church, and I went to that. Pancakes is one of my favorite foods, period. Besides hot dogs. But I do want to try these Eisenberg dogs because that's something I've never tried. I've tried about every dog on the planet. But you know what? Yesterday I interviewed Mark, and he told me about a dog I'd never heard about. And you just told me about one I've never heard about. And so I'm going to try them both. Maybe I'll post up a video in our group or something, do a taste test with some friends and family. But I always have loved Vienna, but they've gotten so expensive.
Yeah, that was another thing.
Yeah, that Jason quit using them too with Love Food Truck. He quit using it because the the expense. They just kept jacking it up. And so I don't know. Steve says he's here from, Steve says, Steve Marino here from California. Thanks for joining us, Steve. David Bloom says, hi, Ben and Jim. Greg Crafton, good morning. I think we're interviewing Greg soon. I think. And Corey just joined in. He says Mormon folks. maybe he meant Mormon. I bet he did. Mormon. So anyway, I'm glad. Well, tell me something, Jim. What has anything happened that you'd like to share that is funny? Something that, I mean, I've had some funny experiences on a cart. You know, I had a guy offer to play the banjo. I've done some stupid stuff, you know, that ended up being funny in hindsight. It wasn't funny at the time, but anything that's happened that sticks out in your mind? I don't mean to put you on the spot, but I didn't know if you had something you wanted to share that would be that people get a kick out of.
I can't think of anything off the top of my head.
All right, then I'm gonna set you up and do a prank or something to you in Savannah and make you a funny story. Cause I'm gonna have to play a practical joke or something on you.
Great.
yeah, Corey says, "Oops, it's more. It's real early." And yeah, he's on Central time, so it's not that early. It's 9, I think, Central for Corey. But Corey hadn't drank enough coffee. He's saying good Mormon. I don't know what else to ask you. That's all I had written down to ask you, Jim. And I really, really appreciate the fact that you would take the time out, especially on your day off, and share with us, because it lets people know that there's people out here that are actually doing this and it exists. And do you have other competition in your area?
There's one other guy that does a hot dog cart in one of the squares, but it's really no, I mean, it's not really competition for me. He doesn't affect me one way or the other.
Well, we've got somebody in here from the Fiji Islands. Welcome, Dean. And then Corey just says, that's the tocket. Instead of that's the ticket, that's the tocket. he ain't woke up yet. Y'all don't know who Corey is. He's got old doggies. We'll be interviewing Corey soon, too. So, there was something else I was going to say about that, the competition. You know, yesterday when I was talking to Mark on here, he talked about competition and how his business has inspired more competition for himself because they've come up asking questions and started a cart. But he said all in all, it hadn't affected him a bit. If anything, it probably helps, you know. It's more out there. You're not the lone wolf. But, and now with Corey's at work and listening at the same time. He's already opened the shop. Well, I guess he would. It's 9. He's got to start cooking. Corey, I'm glad you're here, Corey. Thanks. Even if you're a little dazed and confused. Anybody got any questions they want to ask Jim before we go on the chat room here or the comment? Just put it in the comments and I'll ask him.